Our North Shore reporter Heath Allen says a different sort of storm is brewing there. Heath?
Yeah, the storm that's in the Gulf is really nothing compared to the storm that's actually ashore. It kind of pits the unified command with the Coast Guard against St. Tammany Parish President Kevin Davis. There are two critical issues now. They kind of stand in the middle of this standoff between the unified command and the parish president. The first one is Parish President Kevin Davis is his July the 22nd executive order banning the removal of any equipment or assets being used to protect St. Tammany Parish from the oil that's out in the Gulf of Mexico. The other issue, of course, was that potential storm that was sitting in the Gulf of Mexico. By letter, Admiral Zukov called on Davis to rescind that executive order, calling any interference with personnel acting at the direction of the federal on-scene coordinator a federal offense. He even copied that letter to U.S. Attorney Jim Letton. But with tropical activity lurking in the Gulf, Davis is standing adamant about assets needed to protect St. Tammany Parish from potential flood of oil. The Admiral wants him to rescind that executive order.
Basically what he's asked me to do, and I've responded. I will not remove my executive order, and I will continue to stand up for the people of St. Tammany Parish and all those citizens in Lake Pontchartrain. If it means that they think that the federal government is going to come down here, which I do not believe they have the power to do under this act.
Davis says the Coast Guard has already pulled about 20 of the 31 barges they had in the Wrigley's and Chef Pass protecting this area from the oil. Those have already been pulled. Davis says he's willing to be arrested if necessary to prove his point. On your side here on the North Shore, Heath Allen, WDSU News.
All right, Heath, thanks. And the city of Slidell is offering sandbags tonight. You can pick them up until 10 o'clock tonight at two locations.